Hello, and welcome to today's video presentation on working with the Oracle Linux Storage Appliance and Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. In this video, we will cover the features of the Oracle Linux Storage Appliance web console, configure an NFS share, and then connect to the NFS share from an Oracle Linux 8 client. So let us get started. First, open your browser and log in to the Oracle Linux Storage Appliance web console. The web console within the instance listens on localhost and port 443. Since this instance is on a private network and behind a secure bastion server, use an OpenSSH local port forward to establish a connection. Since configuring the local port on the port forward to 8443, navigate in the browser to https://127.0.0.1:8443. The browser will display the appliance login page. Enter the username of admin and the password created when configuring the appliance. Click the sign in button. After login, the browser refreshes and opens the dashboard page. The dashboard page provides an overview of the storage capacity available for sharing, the number of NFS and SMB clients connected, and information about the appliance resources such as CPU, memory, disk, and network utilization. Using the menu in the upper right, click Storage. The Storage page is where you can view storage capacity available for sharing and create managed shares. While on the Storage page, let us create a share. Start by clicking the Add button. In the Add New Share dialog, enter a share name of Demo. For share size, enter 256 GB. If using legacy 32-bit applications on shares larger than 1 terabyte, then enable the Use 32-bit inodes only toggle by switching it to the right and causing it to turn blue. Next, select the export protocol. Click the Add Export dropdown and select either NFS or SMB export. For this example, select the NFS export. From the default settings, disable the read-only and the required privileged port toggles. A brief description of each of the toggle settings is available by hovering over the gray question mark icon next to the toggle's name. After making the choices, click the Create button. After creating a share, you can perform specific actions against it. Click the Actions drop-down to the right within the specific share section. Next, select either View Modify, Duplicate, Delete, Backup, Restore, or Mount Information. Select the Mount Information item from the drop-down list. The Share Mount and Map Instructions dialog will appear. The dialog gives commands which can be used within your client to connect to the export. Click Close to dismiss the dialog. Back at the top right of this screen, click Appliance. The Appliance page shows platform information, resource utilization, and the status of system services. Items in green indicate OK status, while red indicates potential problems. After reviewing the appliance page details, next, click the administration link in the top right corner. The administration page provides access to view the system, boot, and services logs, and performing additional system and user actions. Some of the actions on this page include the ability to reboot the appliance, update the system packages for security updates, and restarting the NFS and SMB services. Having covered the web console, now use an Oracle Linux 8 instance as a client and connect to the NFS share previously created. First, navigate back to the storage page on the appliance web console. For the demo share created, click the Actions drop-down and select Mount Information. In the NFS Export Mount Command section, copy the mount command presented within the text field. Now, switch to the client machine. Open a terminal and ensure you have the nfs-utils package installed. Type sudo space dnf space install space nfs-utils. Per the output, this client already has the package installed. Next, create the mount point for the NFS share by typing sudo space makedir space /demo. With the mount point created, mount the NFS share using the command provided by the mount information dialog from the appliance web console. Type sudo space mount space dash t space nfs space 10.0.2.14:// shares/demo /demo. With a share mounted, change to the directory by typing cd space forward slash demo. Create a test file in the directory by typing fallocate space dash l space 10 capital G space test.dat. Next, type ls space dash lh to see a listing of the file. With the test complete on the client, return to the browser and refresh the appliance web console. On a storage page, the percent used for the demo share shows some of the space used. Hovering over the percentage provides additional details on space used, the overall size, and the space free. Finally, navigate to the dashboard page. You will see the dashboard retrieving the number of NFS clients attached and eventually return the result of 1. That completes the demo on working with the Oracle Linux Storage Appliance and mounting an NFS share within the Oracle Linux 8 client. Thank you for watching and hope you enjoyed this video. To find additional resources on Oracle Linux, please check out our Oracle Linux curriculum at education.oracle.com/Linux, Oracle Cloud Infrastructure at cloud.oracle.com, and additional training on Oracle Linux on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure at oracle.com/go-to/Linux Cloud Learning.